श्रेयान् स्वधर्मो विगुणः परधर्मात् स्वनुष्ठितात् स्वभावनियतं कर्म कुर्वन्नाप्नोति किल्बिषम्।
Swadharma, one's own duty, even if devoid of merit, is superior to paradharma, another's duty accomplished well. One who performs action dictated by one's own nature does not incur sin. Sin means mental agitation. Sin is in the repercussion of the action. When you perform an action and that boomerangs back on you as one more desire or vasana implanted in your system, that is sin. When you perform an action and that boomerangs back on you as mental agitation, that is sin. But if you are true to yourself, true to your own nature, how can there be sin? Does not incur sin. So, when do you not incur sin? When you follow the previous verse, 46, when you are able to dedicate yourself to that power from whom the whole universe has emanated. Now, if you are not able to lift yourself to that thought, at least you can stretch a little bit. So let's go back, please. We are all working with physical desires. These physical desires are what make you selfish. So when you go rise above the physical and identify with a larger and emotional cause, let's say I work for the welfare of my family, if you say that, there's an instant transformation in you. Because whereas earlier you're only thinking of me all the time, now you're saying, let me see how my actions will benefit my family members. Then you rise to the intellect, identify and accept the whole country as your goal, your field of identification. And then your talent expands, your abilities expand, your energies expand, you become creative and you come up with great results. Go one step further. Atman, spirit, that from which all beings emanate, that which pervades the whole universe, dedicate yourself. So he speaks in 46 of the highest here. If you're not able to go up to here, at least move up from where you are. That's what's important. So now he says, Swadharma is better than Paradharma, and we'll do one last verse, 48.